Good afternoon, one and all. I'm going to discuss about graphs in data structures. So I'm Dr. A. Akila, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, School of Computing Sciences, Wales University. So we are going to see about this data structures graph, which is a nonlinear data structure. So I think all of you know what is nonlinear data structure. So it will not have any, well, like one after this data like that, we don't have any order. So that is what we call it as nonlinear data structure. So we're going to see in this particular session what the about the definition of graph, the terminologies that we used related to graph, the representation, operation, implementation, application, and type of graph. So each thing will be discussed in the forthcoming slides. First, what is the definition for graph? So a graph is a nonlinear data structure, as I mentioned already, that represents the relationship between its adjacent elements. So it will tell you what each elements have any relationship that will be represented by this graph. So there is no hierarchical relationship between the adjacent zones. That means after this, this should occur like that. We don't have any hierarchical order. So, and this is how we represent generally. So G is the graph, which has elements like V and E. V is the vertex or the nodes, and E is the edges that connects between the nodes or between the vertices. The terminologies, the common terminologies that we use in graph is, first one is vertex. As I already mentioned, it is the node in the graph. So in a graph, I'll be having many nodes. Say for example, when I take a city, there are various places. Say when you take Chennai itself, we have places like Annanagar, Ayanavaram. Like that, we have different places. So each of these places are called as vertex. Edges. When you have the edges, the connection or link between the vertex. So say for example, as I mentioned already, there is a road between, there is a link between the city, the place, say Ayanavaram and Annanagar. So that is called as the edge or link. And then adjacent nodes. So when two nodes connect by an edge, the nodes are called as adjacent nodes. So when we have a link between two nodes or two vertex, it's called as adjacent. Those two nodes are called as adjacent nodes. Then self edge. What is mean by self edge? An edge connecting to the same node. That is called as a self edge. Then weight. Between the nodes, we have the edges, and that edges, if has some value, that is called, that is named as weight. Then path, the sequence of edges between two vertices. Say for example, I have a place, say Coimbatore. From Coimbatore, what are all the in between vertices I have to reach a place, say for example Annanagar. So those places which are in between Coimbatore and Annanagar are called as the, that is the path. So what we travel from one vertex to the other vertex, the in between vertices, what and all it is there, that is called as the path. Now we have, I've given an example of some sample graphs. So here I have a graph which has these, so these are all called as the nodes or vertex, and this is called as the edge. So which doesn't have any weight over here. And here I have given an example for self edge. One is having a edge to connecting to itself, to connecting to the same vertex, that is called as a self edge. And we have here this arrow which is having a direction. So this is called as a directed graph. So we will see what are all the different types. Now how we can represent the graph? So that is done by two ways. Actually, adjacency matrix and adjacency list. What is adjacency matrix? How will it represent? So I'll give an example. So this is a sample graph I have represented, where I have three nodes, A, B, and C. So here I have represented in the adjacency matrix, where in the vertical direction also I have all the three nodes represented, and horizontally also I have represented all the three nodes. Now, if there is an edge between the node A or the vertex A and the vertex in the horizontal direction, it will be represented by 1. If it doesn't have an edge, it will be represented by 0. There is no self edge between A to A, so it will be 0. There is an edge between A to B, so this is the edge, so I represented it by 1. When I have a edge between A and C, I have here, so it is represented as 1. So like this, we represent an edge by 1, and there is no edge, it is represented by 0 in adjacency matrix. Now, the second representation we have is adjacency list, where I have all the three nodes in a static sort of thing, and which will be having, this is a separate link, and this is again a separate link where it has all its adjacency matrix. So here we have A, which is having the address adjacency matrix as B and C, so which all are having a link, and there is no node after C, so only B and C are connected. So after C, I have represented the link part. You know that this is a data linked list representation, where I have the data part and followed by the address part at the link part. So this link will be null, which is represented by a slash. And now we have C, B node, which is having the nodes connection. There is the edges with A and C nodes. So that is represented here. So it is having C, and then it is having a link between A also. So that is represented here. Now, when we go for C, similarly, it will have link with A, and there is the edge between A and B. So that is how it is represented as a adjacency list. Now we go for the operations. What are all the commonly used operations? Most commonly used operations. So first one is add vertex. So I want to add a new vertex to the graph. Then that I can do it with this add vertex operation. Add edge. So I've created a vertex, and I'm going for creating an edge between the two vertices. That I can do it with this operation called as add edge. Then display vertex will display all the graph vertex that is available in that particular graph. Then we have the next very important operation, traversal. How I can visit, how I can travel through the graph, that is called as the traversal operation. So there are two type of traversal available, actually depth first search and traversal and breadth first search traversal. So what is depth first search traversal? It is depthward motion. It is traverse through the depthward motion and uses stack to remember the next vertex to start. So that is how it is done. So we have three rules to be followed, commonly used rules. What is that? First rule one, visit the adjacent unvisited vertex. Once visited, mark the vertex as visited vertex. We will see an example in the next slide. So push it into the stack. So once you have an unvisited vertex, visit it and mark it as visited vertex. So and have that inside a stack. If no adjacent vertex are found or all the adjacent vertex are visited, then what you have to do is whatever you have inserted into the stack, we have to pop it out. So repeat rule 1 and 2. There is this one insertion and the popping. There is push and pop operation until the stack is empty. So we have an example here. So I have this graph where I have represented it as adjacency matrix. So I have given the adjacency matrix representation. Now I am going for depth first search. So first I will be visiting the vertex A. So that is the start with the vertex A. So when you see here, it's having the first vertex A. So it will start with here, and now it will insert that, mark it as that is being visited. So it will be marked as visited and push it into the stack. So I have in the stack the vertex A. Next, when I go for the next one, so visit, find the adjacent vertex. So vertex A has adjacency with B, C and D, all the three. So you can see here, so it has the adjacency vertex B, C and D. How it is having adjacency? I can tell that it is adjacent nodes. A is having an edge between A and B. A is having an edge between A and D. A is having an edge between A and C also. So it is all the three nodes are adjacent nodes. So when I go for that, then B, C, D are unvisited. All the three are unvisited. So first we will be visiting B. So visit B, push it into the stack. Now you should not see the other things. You have to go for now, check with the B only. So here, find the adjacency vertex of B. Again, B is adjacent to all the nodes A, C and D. And here, A is already visited. C and D are only not visited, unvisited vertex. So it will be visiting C. So that is what I've given here. So visit C and push it into the stack. Now, the last one. So now I'm going to check with the vertex C what are all the adjacent. So it has the adjacent vertices A, B and D. Out of these, A and B are visited already. So only D is unvisited. So that will be visited and that will also be pushed into the stack. Now it will check out what are all the unvisited vertices, adjacency vertices of D. None, all the three are visited. So then it will go for C. So here we have C, which is again having the A, B and D, all the three are visited. So it will go for B. A, C and D are the adjacent vertices. All the vertices are visited. So it completes the traversal. So what happens? It pop out every element. So D, it checks for any unvisited vertices. Then C, then B, then A. So it will be in the order A, B, C and D. This will be the order of visiting the nodes, traversing through the nodes in depth first search. Now we will see how to do it with breadth first search. So what is breadth first search? It will be traversing a graph in breadthward motion. So we will be using a queue to remember the next vertices to search. So there are again three rules followed here. Visit the adjacent unvisited vertex. Once visited, mark again the same thing, but instead of inserting, pushing it into the stack over there in depth first search, here in breadth first search we are inserting it into the queue. And you all know that queue have two ends, the front end and the rear end. So the front end will be used for all sort of deletions and rear end will be used for insertion. So we have the thing. So if no adjacent vertices found or all the adjacent vertices are visited, remove the vertex from the queue. So that is what we will be seeing an example, the same example I have here. Now how it is done with breadth first search. So start with vertex A, mark as visited and insert into the queue. So I've inserted that into the rear end. Now next, find the adjacent vertices. What are all the adjacent vertices of A? We have already know that it is B, C and D. So all the three are unvisited. So visit B, then C and then D. So it will be in that order. So it will be taking that particular vertex A. What are all the adjacent vertices of that? That will be visited. And then only it goes for the next node. So it has three adjacent vertices B, C, D. So all the three will be visited. This is what the case of breadth first search. When I take a vertex, all its adjacent vertices will be visited in breadth first search. But that is not the case in the depth first search. So what happens? Visit B, then C and D. So insert B, C, D in the same order into the queue. So B will be inserted first, then C and then D. So insertion takes at the rear end and deletion takes place at the front end. So remove A from Q. So because all the adjacency vertices of A is visited, so remove it. Now we go for B. So it has the adjacent vertices A, C and D. All are visited. So remove B from the Q. Next, when we have C, it again has the adjacent vertices A, B and D. So I have this. So what happens? All are visited again. So remove that also from queue. Now we have the last one. When we go for D, I'm going to have A, B, C as the adjacency vertices. All are visited. So remove D also. So here in this particular example, both breadth first search and depth first search has the same path A, B, C and D. I've given one more example here. It's example 2. Which has 5 nodes A, B, C, D and E, where when I go for depth first search, how it will be done? First A, so what are all the adjacency vertices of that? B, C and E, all the 3 nodes. Out of this, it will be visiting B. After B, it will be searching for B's adjacency vertices A and D. A is already visited, so it visits D. Now, the D adjacent vertices B, C and E B is already visited, so it visits C. Now it will check for C's adjacency vertices. A and D both are visited, so it comes back to the previous one. So which was the previous vertices visited? D. So from that it will travel to the next one, E. So that will be the next path. So it will be in the order A, B, D, C and E. When I go for breadth first search, it will be visiting first A, node A, that is vertex A. From that it will be going for all its adjacency vertices, so B, C and E. And then it will go for the next one, B's adjacency vertices, which are all unvisited. A and D I have. A is visited, so it travels to D. So A, B, C, E, D. So this is how it is traversing through depth first search and breadth first search. Now how can I implement it? Actually there are two ways of implementing a concept of graph. So how can I do it? Using array. So when I go for having an array representation, I'm going to have two arrays. One is for having all the vertices and one is for representing the adjacency matrix. But here when you want to add any new vertices in the middle, it's very complicated because you have to push all the other vertices right or left, and then all the adjacency matrix also should be translated. The next one is using implementation using linked list. So here each vertex and this adjacent vertices are represented by separate linked list. You can see an example here. I have three nodes. So here A I have, so it is represented as a separate list, linked list, which has two link part. One is linked to the adjacency vertices and one link to the next vertex. So I have all two links. So this will be having what are all the edges connected to it. So A is connected to B and C, so I have a connectivity here. And when I go for B, it has one connectivity only with A, so it has a link only with that A linked list. So this is how we represent a graph using linked list. Now what are all the applications, general applications of graph? Traveling salesman problem. What is traveling salesman problem? A salesman has to travel from one city to the other. How, which is the shortest path of that? He has to travel and he has to cover all the places. That is called as traveling salesman problem. To solve this particular one, we use this graph. And then Facebook. We all are using this Facebook and Google Map. So when we use Facebook, we are representing each user of that particular app, that is Facebook, as vertex. And when two people are friends, they have a connection link. So that is called as an edge. Then we go for Google Map. The third example application we have is Google Map. So various locations, when I just have places, that in the locations in the Google Map are the vertex, and the road connecting the locations are called as the edges. Now we come for the last one, that is the type of graph. I've listed the graph types. So first is directed graph, undirected graph, complete graph, multi graph, simple graph, weighted graph, isolated graph, null graph, connected graph and strongly connected. We'll see one by one. So directed graph, a graph whose edges are directed from one node to the other. Let's see this example. I have a direction arrow mark representing the connectivity. So that is called as a directed graph. Undirected graph, there is an edge but that doesn't have an arrow mark. That is called as a undirected graph. Complete graph, when I have the vertices, every node, it is adjacent to all the other nodes in the graph, it is called as a complete graph. You can see that A is connected to B, C and D. B is connected to A, D and C. C is connected to A, B and D. D is connected to A, B and C. So if all the nodes are connected to or adjacent to all the other nodes in the graph, it's called as a complete graph. Then multi-graph, when I have an edge, multiple edges between two vertices, it's called as a multi-graph. So you can see that from A to C, I have two edges, One is this and one more is this. Next is weighted graph. We have, so where I have a value represented in the edge, it's called as a weighted graph. So here we have 4, 11 and 9, which represents the weightage between the connectivity between A and B vertices. Now isolated graph, when I go for any graph which doesn't have any link, no adjacent node, it is called as a isolated node. And a graph that contains an isolated node, it's called as a isolated graph. So you can see that here in this example, node A or the vertex A is isolated node. And this graph, as it contains the isolated node, it's called as a isolated graph. Null graph, a graph which contains isolated node without edges, that is only the isolated node or no node, it's called as a empty graph or null graph. So we have the next one, next type is connected graph, where I have a graph in which every node can be reached from other node. Say, what is the difference between this and complete? Complete graph will have all the other vertices as its adjacency vertices. But here, it is not a must that it should have it as a adjacency vertices, but it should be reachable from any vertex to any. Say, for example, I want to reach from A to C, I can directly go here, or A, B, D and C. If I want to travel from A to D, I don't have a direct link, but I can reach from A to B, then to D, or A to C and then to D. So if I am able to reach any node from any other node, it's called as a connected graph. Strongly connected. What is mean by strongly connected? A directed graph is strongly connected if for every pair of node there exists direct edge from first node to the second node and from a directed edge from the second. Say here you can see the example, A and C has both way connectivity, there is link edge. A to C I have a connectivity edge, and from C to A also I have an edge. So this one is called as a strongly connected graph. Thank you.